Well, my name is Ashley Reed. I'm originally from Kentucky. I moved to Inglewood in 2016. And what really brought me here was the community. I really just love being in a space where I see people who look like me. And I just fell in love. So right now I'm just really setting roots here. I've chosen to start my business in Inglewood because for me, there was a void. I've lived in a lot of different neighborhoods, and specifically being able to go to a yoga studio in different neighborhoods, and some neighborhoods have multiple options. And when you look here, there's just not one right now. And so I really think that the people of Inglewood deserve something like this. I tried yoga many years ago. It was when I was living in Chinatown with some roommates. So there was three of us living in a space, and the two girls were just like, hey, we're going to yoga. I was like, all right, cool, I've never been. So, you know, we packed up, we got in the car, we went to the studio. And years later, I was working in the fashion industry. Like I said, I went to fashion school, and that's how I got here. And I worked for a major company, and they were like laying off people. So every few months there was like layoffs and layoffs. And so one day my number came up and it was my time to go. And as a result of that, I got to step back and kind of reevaluate my life. So I started to kind of look what was in my neighborhood, and at the time I was in downtown. And I found myself in walking distance of that very same studio that I went to so many years ago. And it was such a different experience. For the first session, I think I cried afterwards. Like I was like, oh God, this feels so good. One of the things that was so incredible, and I will always tell like how awesome the founder of Yoga Bliss is, her name is Flores-Lopez, and she talked about everything and basically was an open book. She asked us in our training, like, what did you want to do with your training? And I was like, well, one day I'm going to open a yoga studio in my community. And she was like, one day, we can do that today. I finished my training in 2019 in November, well, October, and then by November I'd already applied for the business name. I was already looking for places. And the rest is kind of history. I mean, obviously we would have liked to start in 2020, like the physical space, but you know, Corona came, and it has allowed me the space to be such a better teacher. I said it allowed me the space to slow down, to get some infrastructure going on because I didn't have it, but that's what happens when you're new in business. You just kind of go forward, learn from your mistakes and keep pushing. I think I enjoy just allowing people the space to relax, the space to explore whatever is going on, whether that be mentally, emotionally, physically, and just being supported. I might not understand everybody's issue, and things hit at a different space. Being able to say like, here, just take a moment, take a pause. I'm not gonna pretend like you don't feel. There's so much that I enjoy in the satisfaction of what I do. So I wanted to really just offer people something. And what I could offer them was a practice, you know, just to be able to relax and tell them that it's gonna be okay. That's like one of my favorite things I say in the class. I always remind people, like, build a foundation of the earth beneath you. Know that you're supported, know that you have everything inside you to move forward, because again, all day we're in our head telling ourselves some other stuff. So just being able to reinforce that. As the community is changing, because we know that it's changing, it's super important for me or anybody who wants to start this community, who's a part of the community, to get in now, because, you know, somebody else is going to do this, and they might not look like me, and they might not care about this community the way that I care about it. So that's really also a big sense of urgency, like why as soon as I trained, I was like, all right, well, we got to get it popping. There's a lot of stuff happening, and that's why I was willing to jump out without having that much, like, that much experience, but I've gained so much experience over this last year, and again, so much to gain. So that's why I want to stay here. I think it's a beautiful place. I love that I can go out and see people doing all things, having all businesses here, and they look and represent this space. So all these different places that exist here already. And so being able to support that and continue to build upon that, that's what's important to me. I want us, again, to stay present in spite of like what's going on outside and the people that they're gonna bring in. So being able to know that there's people who already believe in this community and just like support that, but yeah, right here. And I think it's important for us to be able to focus on our wellness too, because again, you go to a different neighborhood and they have options of this type and that type and this, and just being able to say, like, here's one type. And I think something that's important that has to be said is, just because I exist, you can exist, and anybody else who wants to exist can exist, because there's so many people to serve. And although I have not experienced a lot of pushback from other people, I've actually gotten so much support from a lot of people. Sometimes people think that if you're the Black, that you're the Black and you don't get to have others. And I don't think that that has to be true, because you can have my experience versus somebody's experience is going to be completely different, and you're going to serve completely different markets, but they're all needed, they're all necessary. So just saying that, like, if you have the idea and you want to serve your neighborhood or this and that, don't not do it because somebody else is already doing it. Do it in a way that's yours and that's authentic, and you'll connect. Finish him. I'm Desdemona, Othello and tragedies, Shakespeare and Saul.